Welcome, everyone. Another episode of the Car Mechanic Simulator. We are with this car this time. This is the FMW Panther, which is very, very rusted out beyond belief. I went ahead before we started this episode and ran the tests. All the tools. I ran all the scanner, pressure test, the thread tester, the electronic and compression. I ran them all. It's looking like everything in this car is going to be parts. A lot of parts under the car. Like this back here, you can see all this messed up. That's all going to need replaced. But first thing I am going to do is replace the parts that are broke. In the car status, we have to replace the bumper B left and right front fenders, and bumper B in the rear. I'm gonna guess that we don't have to change the license plate because they're not on here. Usually you do though, but I'm gonna go ahead and say we don't for now. Headlight B, you notice how it says B? Usually when we did this, it just had a right fender. There was no letters on the end. These ones have letters. Reason for that, we're gonna go into the thing here. You see how we go to the body workstation, go to the Panther. You don't see front bumper B, not in here. Neither is rear bumper B. It's not in here either. So the only thing we can get in here is the front left fender, right fender, and we need, oh, that's it. Yeah, because the other one is B2. So that's it. Out of here, we just need the fenders. Now, when you go back and you go to, let's see here, I think it's the body tuning shop. Yep, it is. Here is your front bumper B. This is for more of the, I like to call it the flashy cars. I think we got the left one, didn't we? Yeah, we did. Darn it. Pretty made a mistake. Oh, look how good that one looks without that one. Let's change it. All right. Okay. Now with them on, go back to the car status. Front bumper B. Did we get the front bumper B? I think we did. Yep, we did. And then you put this plate back on. Now that is done. We can factory spray this now. I think it's really dumb how that's gonna look, but oh well, it is what it is. Go over here. Factory spray. Right here, you just click factory color. If you're going to be having your own car, you would just pick the current color and pick whatever you want, and you can change the paint type by clicking over, and they have different kinds. But we're just doing stock for now. So. And now. It looks like junk. But all it asks for. Remember, it's not your car. There's a race tire that's broke. It's probably like back there with the same one of that rim that's broke. That whole side's broke. So what we're going to do, we're going to look around this car and we're going to see what's broke. Rusted out bolts, the oil is V8, it needs changed. Back here. Tolan's tire thing needs ripped off. What do you do, like run over a curb or something? Jeez. All right, so let's see now. All right, that is everything. So the brake caliper, brake itself. The oil is a V8. You need a race tire. A lot of rear stuff. We need the axle. Knuckle A. Drive axle. Spring. Suspension, arm, ambi, and upper arm, all of it, literally. Fuel hub, rim 18A. Real Hub 3. All right. So, hold on. Before we even do that, go in our inventory. Look for the tire we just ripped off. $235.35.18. Now we can go look. We need a race tire. Race tire 18, 235. Back, go to rims. We need a rim 18A. There. We need that. And 18. Okay. A Y went the whole way out. And here we need a caliper, we need a disc, and we need the brake. Back over here. Oil, we need a B8. Let me see. Everything is in rear, so let's start rear A, right? Yep. One, rear drive axle, another. Need the end link. That. Need that. Need that. I think that's it. Let's see here. Let's put this tire together. You can get a cap. Not cup, cap. All right, just the oil. Go up here. Come out, put the oil filter back on. Dagger over here, drain her out. Oh, don't do that. Right. Bring it on down. I wonder in the next car mechanic, whenever they make it, if we're going to have to finally unscrew down there for the oil to come out instead of it just going automatically and squirting out. All right. Car is completely done. Remember to always get rid of all the extra stuff. Barnyard location. We're gonna have a crap load of those. We got a couple stray cars we have to do. Just the A. This V8 OHV and the Cadillac converter. As you play the game more and you get so familiar with the parts, things go a lot quicker. Other tasks, refill everything. All right, good to go. See, this one's just fluids. Just gotta change the oil. I wish it was this fast in real life. But nope, when you go change your oil, you're literally sitting there forever waiting. this one's going to have more issues. Knocking sound coming from suspension. Car is hard to handle. Running gear. Brake problems. Change brake fluid. Alrighty. Let's run some tests. One more. Good news is the knocking isn't the pistons, so we can rule that out. Oh, that's one right there. I already tell you that just by looking at it. Brake pad. And that might be the other one. Over to this tire. I already tell you, this rod right here is probably another one. No, one wasn't discovered. What was that under? Brake problems. Might be this. It might be that ABS up there. Why is it? I was gonna say, what the heck? All right, there's that. Do them one at a time. Or end link. I think it's the rear B. Let's look. Oh, it's A. Calibers 1-1 brake pad. Guess his brake problems are down here. I'm gonna go with more than likely it said ABS up top. Hey, should bump and just. Like, it is not a lot of money to do this. Part mount. It's like, why be stingy when it don't even cost much at all? I mean, we got 20,000. All right. Here. Let's see if it's this. still got one more part that isn't discovered. A running gear part. About this thing. No, not that. It looks like crap. They can get tricky. They really can on what part it is. Can get tricky. And it's not always what you would think it would be either. General running gear control and repair. I hope it's nothing with... I don't think it would be in the transmission, but I could be wrong. Could be in the transmission for all I know. Let's look. I don't think it would be. I think it would just be a normal part that's broke. Just not seeing one that is. Maybe. Is this tie rod maybe? Don't think it would be in there. Let's pull the tires back off. You do deal with cars like this where it can get a little bit. Eesh. It can get annoying. It really can. I'm going to pull this off. We're going to look in the transmission. We're going to look into it. I'm just curious because remember we changed the drive shaft here and it was broke. You remember? So if that's the case, maybe something inside of it's broke. We're about to find out. Nope. Clean as a whistle. So it has to be just a regular running part. There is some part that is just really low. I just don't know which one. We gotta figure that out. Thing is, like, the part that it's under, running gear control and repair, the sway bar and the rubber bushing is with it. So, is it another rubber bushing that's broke somewhere? That would be my next thing. Is that it's a rubber bushing or something? I thought there was a way to look at broken parts, like how bad the parts are. I guess there isn't.
Huh. I wonder what it is. Like, I'm totally stumped on what it could be. That's why I've been just pulling parts, trying to figure it out. You got me totally freaking stumped right now. That whole thing's brand new, so it can't be that. I feel like it's just some freaking rubber bushing or something somewhere that's just broke or something. But it's not. So I pulled that completely off. It's not that. Pulled both of the shocks off. I pulled all four shocks off at that. Not none of the shocks. And it says general running gear control and repair. Let's take the oil out of this. Let me see something here. See if it's a rod or something down here at the bottom. Maybe this is it. Nope, that's not it either. I'm unbelievably stumped. Unbelievably stumped right now. Huh. I hope this isn't glitched. That's what I'm hoping, because it does happen. It does happen. It could be glitched. And that just sucks. Because I don't see, we literally have ripped off all parts except for this big cross member, but it's not that. It's not beat up enough. It can't be that. It'd be worthless just to rip it all off. Like, I really don't know what else it possibly could be. Maybe this right here. That looks badly rusted. Is that it? Nope. I'm clueless. We already pulled off all the sway bars. We pulled all that stuff off. It's gotta be something that is just a normal part around the car. It has to be. It's not something. It's a wear and tear part. It's gotta be a wear and tear part that's just not going right? I have no idea. Gotta be a wear and tear part. does either. Four, and that's the one we just put in. Fifty-something. I don't think I could, like, forties. I have no idea. 60s. Like I said, it might be a glitch. Because nothing. I have literally pulled almost all parts off of this car. Kind of ridiculous at this point. It's not even a story car at that. It's crazy to me that it hasn't popped up yet, and I have literally ripped off everything. I wonder something. Let me... Nope, that's fine. I thought it maybe was that, maybe the one of the hidden rubber bushings. I was like, oh, might be it. And I'm still wrong. The only thing, there is no tester for all these rubber bushings. There's nothing for that. Pretty much just eyeballing it and hoping that you find it. A little warning of the game when you play it that you might run into stuff like this. And like, everything has been ripped off, so I really don't know what else it could be. I pulled all the shocks off, I pulled all these parts off, and nothing is popping up. So I'm gonna chalk it up as the game glitched. Which it happens. It does happen. No game is perfect, that's for sure. I literally almost made 100 XP on just ripping parts off 1,000 times, like... Yeah. No idea. No idea. Rubber bushing still missing. And you will run into cars like this. I'm telling you guys, you will run into cars like this, and there's no other way. Like, unless someone knows a way to do this, oh, please, in the comments, please let me know, because I have this problem a lot, where I can literally tear apart the whole entire car, and I have yet to find the problem. And I was told, well, it could be, you know, something you're just not looking at. And I was like, well, I pulled off everything. Like, all these fuses have all been tested. It's like, what else is there to really do? I pulled all this, all these shocks have been pulled off. All the parts surrounding all these shocks have been pulled off. The only thing that hasn't been pulled off is that cross member, and it ain't damaged enough to even care. That's what I mean. Like, what else could it be? Literally nothing. Crazy. Does happen though. It sucks, but what can you do? One. See, it should be easy like that. Alrighty. That is our a level 9. We got 3 available points. We use one right here. And our next story car. Oh, it's a big van. Need a lot of work. Holy crap. 8 pages. Wow. All right, guys. That was it for this episode. Thank you all for tuning in. I know it's a little long because we got stuck on the whole car, but it does happen. If you're not following, hit the subscribe button down below. I greatly appreciate that. All the links are down below, too, if you want to check all them out and follow me other places. And I will see you on the next episode of Car Mechanic Simulator.